Hello, I'm Graham and welcome to today's video, which is an introduction to the series where we're looking at modern digital camera sensor technology. In this series I hope to be covering off the differences between the technologies involved with sensors, so that's going to be the CCD and CMOS type, but I'll also be looking at the way fabrication of sensor technology has moved so that we can actually embed the sensors to give us contrast and phase detection to drive our autofocus systems in our modern cameras. However, in today's video, I want to start by looking at answering a question: does size matter? Does actually cramming any more pixels onto any given sensor size improve the image quality? Let's begin by looking at just how many pixels we need to display our image in a modern digital world. For example, you might want to display your image on something like this, a Kindle Fire HD, which has a HD display, 1260 by 768, at something like 133 dpi. We also might want to look at them on a TV display, and again in our modern technology system we have 2K screens which are 1920 by 1080. Again, our laptops and our PC monitors all emulate HD resolution 16:9 format, either 1260 by 768 or 1920 by 1080. Alternatively, we may want to make prints, and a recent survey I conducted on my photoblog site suggested that we only now print at 6x4. Very few people actually produce prints anymore, and in fact the ones that do limit them to 6x4. Very few people now produce anything larger than 10x8 prints. If we look at the number of pixels required to either give us a 2K display or a 6x4 print, you'll find it's nowhere near something like the 80 megapixels that we see in modern compact digital cameras. In fact, in reality, for a HD display of 2K size, we only need 2K pixels. So that's 2 megapixels. We only need 1920 by 1080. So even if I display the image from a 22 megapixel camera to the HD screen of HDMI, the camera will be binning pixels because it only needs to send 2K pixels to that display device. And it's the same when we print a print. Modern inkjet printers normally require something like 300 dots per inch to produce a very high quality print. A lot, of course, will depend on the viewing distance of either the print or your television. The recommended viewing distance for either device is going to be 1.5 times the diagonal. So in this case, a 6x4 print has a diagonal of 7.25 inches. So multiply that by 1.5 and the actual theoretical viewing distance is going to be about 11 inches. So if I view this print from 11 inches, I'll see exactly what is meant to be seen on a 6x4 inch print, the highest resolution, and you get a beautiful image. The same fundamental rule applies to when you're watching a large format TV. So for example, if you have a 50 inch LED TV, the diagonal of that multiplied by 1.5, when you're looking at a 1080p image, you can be sitting something like 6 feet away from it, just over 2 meters. If you look at a lower resolution image on that screen, if you're looking at a 720p image, then you'll notice pixelation at that distance and you have to move further away. And the recommended viewing distance on that size of screen for a 720p image is actually 10 feet or 3 meters. If you were looking at a VGA resolution on that size of screen, you'd have to sit further back still to get away from pixelation. It's the same with prints. You can actually print, say, a 16 by 20 print with nothing like 300 dpi. If you print it at something like 90 dpi and look at it from the correct viewing distance of about 40 inches, that print will appear as sharp as if it was printed on a 6x4 and viewed at 11 inches. And it's the same with something like these big advertising hoardings. They appear to be remarkably sharp. You can actually see hairs on model shoulders and things like that. But if you walk up to those displays and look at them closely, you'll find they're made up of very large dots, something like 20 or 30 dpi, nothing like 300 dpi that we need for these smaller prints. So the larger the print or the larger the display, the lower the resolution it needs to be if we're sitting at a further distance to appreciate a good quality image. So why do we need 18 megapixels if we're only going to produce a 2K display or a 6x4 inch print? To answer that question, let me show you a set of images that I've produced with a digital camera ranging from 12 megapixels down to 2 megapixels. And as we step through these images, you'll not notice any difference in image quality from the highest resolution of 12 to the lowest resolution of 2 megapixel. That's the way that the screens work. We can actually use low resolution images to display on a higher resolution screen. So even though you've got a 50-inch plasma TV, it's only a 2K resolution screen, so we only need 1920 by 1080 pixels to fill that screen. Any more than that, and the actual processor within the television is actually pixel binning. It's throwing away some information, it doesn't need it. So even though you start off with an 18 megapixel image, when your TV displays it, you're actually looking at just 2K pixels. Do we need all those 18 megapixels to create an image for display on a HD device or a television screen? Or even do we need it for printing at 6x4? Well, the answer is in two parts. One is that we may want to crop into that image to improve our composition. Or we may want to simulate something like a telephoto crop. Again, if you crop into the image, it's simulating you zooming in with your camera when you took the first shot. My answer to the first question is improve the composition before you take the shot. Walk up to your subject or move further back, get it framed exactly how you want it, and then take the picture. Don't rely on post-process cropping to get the composition you want, or don't rely on zooming to get the composition you want. Change the lens to a prime lens, move up to where you want, take the picture, you've got the best possible image quality you'll get from that camera and sensor combination. So in theory, if we only wanted a 2K display, we only need a 2K resolution camera. And in fact, the first digital camera that I was involved was a 1 megapixel camera that Kodak produced back in the early 1990s. And that was capable of producing a 3.5 inch by 5 inch print with acceptable viewing parameters. In fact, the first of the professional Canon digital cameras again had something like a 6 megapixel image. So why do we now need 18 megapixel? And the answer to that, of course, is marketing. Marketing can only drive camera sales through something it can define to its customers, and they can define pixels as a way to improving image resolution. And image resolution doesn't exactly just mean how sharp that print is or how clear it is. There's a lot of factors that go into actually the print or image resolution, as we'll discuss in the next video. So, in truth, we don't need anything like the 18 megapixels that we're being forced to look at these days in compact digital cameras. I started by asking the question, does size matter? Well, size does matter if you want to consider dynamic range. You'll get more dynamic range if you add a larger photosite. That's the area of the sensor which gathers the light. A larger site can actually give you more of a dynamic range. It can collect more of the photons that our light waves generate. Smaller sensors need more amplification, which could be more noise, and that destroys the image quality. If our target device was a printer, then of course we would need more pixels on the original sensor to drive the 300 dpi needs of our inkjet printers. So as we move on towards the higher end cameras now, we're talking between 20 and 25 megapixels. Again, it's a marketing ploy to try and get you to buy a camera based on specification rather than needs through performance. I'm hopefully going to show that in the next video. I've shot the same scene with a range of digital cameras ranging from 2 megapixel all the way up to 25 megapixel, and you'll be astounded at the quality that's coming out from those lower pixel cameras compared to the higher ones. That's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. If you're a new viewer to the channel and haven't subscribed, please consider clicking the subscribe button. I also have a photographic blog site, and again, I'll put a link to that in the description below. On that blog site, you'll find all sorts of material relating to photography. There's a download section where there are some hints and tips card. There's a link to my free FZ200 ebook if you want to download that. And if you subscribe to the newsletter, then you will be entered into prize draws. For example, this week ending on the 9th of February will be a prize draw for a set of 3 close-up lenses. That's the number 1, the number 2, number 4, in a 52mm filter mount size. And the recipient can be anywhere in the world. I'll pass it out free of charge to that person. So you must be a subscriber to the newsletter to enter into that prize draw. So until my next video, thanks again for watching. Take care and bye for now.